Hey guys, this is Prabhat Malhotra and this is our first tutorial for Mern Stack Realtime project. So without doing any delay, let me start what we are gonna do in this all tutorial series. So what we are gonna do is we'll be working on React.js and NodeJs. That is, how do we create real-time project, what kind of approach do we use. So we are gonna see all those. Okay, so without doing any delay, let me start. Let me open my command prompt first. As you can see here, anyway, I'm gonna use Visual Studio, so I'll be using the integrated terminal. But let me create one folder. Sorry, I have already created one folder. I'll tell you that what I have. So let me open my command prompt cmd. And I'm opening my Visual Studio code by command code dot in Windows 10. I don't know how it works in Windows 7 or Linux, but maybe it will work out there also. So as you can see, my Visual Studio has already opened. Let me close this, and this is gonna be introduction video, guys. So I'll tell you what are we gonna learn this. Let me delete my project here, and just a minute, guys. Okay, so I've deleted my project, previous project, and yes. So this is gonna be the introduction video. Very first, we'll have the introduction. As I told you, we are gonna learn Mern Stack tutorial. This is gonna be Mern Stack, and we are gonna learn React.js with Node.js. How do we use them together, and how do we make our totally full stack project? And then we have to setting up a project with our Express Generator. How do we set up our project with Express Generator command? And that we will see in this video. And understanding and modifying Node.js course. That is a simple project setup you get from the Express Generator, and we will see here how do we change, how do we understand this, and that's it gonna be the for the first video. I don't want to make this longer. So as you can see, this is my command prompt, integrated terminal, what you call in Visual Studio code. I love this IDE. If you want, you can use any other IDE, doesn't matter. But if you are on Visual Studio code, you can go to the view, you can do integrated terminal, and you can find your terminal here. So it was already open, so it got closed. I'm again opening. Okay, so what are we gonna do is we are gonna come to this Express Generator, that is expressjs.com, and here you can see Express Generator, application generator. And first of all, you are gonna install this command. That is, you're gonna set up environment for your project. It won't give you anything, it will just set up the environment. Okay, so copy this command, paste here, and it will take some time. So we'll develop our project from very scratch, one by one. I will tell you how do we work with the Node, how do we work with the React, how do we combine both of them, and how we start both the server by running a single command. By using concurrency package, we can do that, and I'll show you all those things. So this is gonna be a very interesting series. As you know, React.js is in very demand, and I love working with React rather than Angular. So the very next command that we are gonna use is this command. So you can see express dash dash view bug my app. What is this? I'll explain you. Let me install this first, and it will be installing, and then meanwhile I'll tell you, because it will take some time. Sorry guys. And let me paste this. So what it does is, express is the command, and view means Node.js is having several template engines, like say bug, EJS, JED, etc. we have. So I'm gonna use EJS. I'm not gonna use bug, as EJS is more handy to use. According to me, you can use anyone, doesn't matter. Anyhow, we are not going to use this, because we'll be using React.js, so no need of any template engines. But for starting purpose, for the demo purpose, let us do this. and then you have to give your project folder name. What is gonna be the name of your project? So let me give that. Give it as React Devils. Okay, React Devils, or we can say Mern Devils. I think we can call. It's up to you. What do you call this? Mern Devils. Okay. So as you can see, I'm starting. You get a folder here, and inside that, you come to this folder, you get every file here. But you can't see node module. Why? Because you have to do that separately. Okay. So first of all, as you can see here, you get some kind of instructions here. Change directory, go to the cd mern devils, and then you can do npm install, and then you can run your project by npm start. Okay, so let me do that, and then you can get the node modules here. Okay, so I'm gonna get into the my project folder, that is mern devils. Yep, I am inside the project folder, and then I can run npm install. What it does is, whatever the here is your package.json, whatever modules are there in your package.json, as you can see, these are the modules: cookie parser, debug, EJS, and HTTP errors, express, Morgan. So it installs every package in the node module. Okay, so let me run this. It will take some time. So meanwhile, what I'll do is I'll walk you through these folders, what are these gonna do. So let me close this help.txt. package.json is nothing but whatever you install in your project, you get every information regarding your project. So as you can see, name is mern devils, person, private, script, start. So whenever we run our project, we can run by npm start. As you can see, it has installed our node modules, and you can see this folder here. Cool. So if you go inside this folder, you can find all your packages. Okay, and then yeah, nothing to do inside that. We'll see that later. And exactly, we don't do anything. We just install the packages inside that. That's it. And then what we'll do is we'll just run our project by going to npm start. Okay. Yes. I'll tell you how does it work. And as you can see, it has been started. And if you go to the localhost, that is localhost 3000, you can see the, yeah, you can see express, welcome to express. And where is it coming from? Let me explain. So as you can go to the routes, so first of all, you go to your routes and index.js. okay. As you can see, we are having two routes by default, okay, index and users. So come to your app.js. Let me explain you this. So what is index.js is, here you are adding all your functions, all your functionalities, and of course in future we are gonna write our separate controller and separate routes, but for now we are having like controller. This is your controller, and route in a single phase, so we are not bothered right now. So that's it. We are calling this command, that is by default home, you can say very index command we are using here. And then you are giving the title here as express. Let me give here as mern devils. Okay, and since we are not having node mon at this stage, so we'll have to restart our server every time. Let me save this, and then we can restart our server. Sorry, npm start. Okay, did I save? If we have saved, then after refreshing we should get that. Yeah, so if you refresh, it will give you this. Okay guys, this is gonna be very introduction video, so don't bother. I'll not pass your time. I'll take you through the real-time project very soon. Okay, so this is our routes, and let's close this. We are not gonna use, as you want to see what is the user's route is there for. So come to your users, and you can see this is coming from the user's route. We will be making our own routes. So currently at this stage we don't want this. Let me delete this route. Delete. Okay. Only we have this index route. So in app.js, as you can see, where are we? How are we using that? How are we calling that? Is we have the HTTP errors. We have the modules that we are calling here: Express, Path, Cookie Parser, Morgan. They are the modules that we are using. And one by one, we'll explain you. I will explain you in the upcoming videos. And this is now we don't have this file, users.js file. So we can remove this. Otherwise, it will show you error. Okay, so here we are setting our views. How, where is your views? App set views, path join. This is the directory name views. Views means this one. And from here you are rendering index.ejs, and from here you are getting your title. Welcome to, and title is coming from the routes, as you can see here. So yeah, title you can see here. Title, this is your key. This is as like object, and this is the modern which is your title. So let me close this. Close this, and template engine, that is view engine we are using, is EJS. As I while installing we have used that. Here is everything you can see. Just whatever the middleware we are using, you have to give here. Okay. app.use/. So whatever you give here, you get in the browser. Okay. So anyhow, we are not using this. Okay. So now, if you want to see, this is the very simple, very index route. So they have given just slash. That is, that takes you the. So whenever you load your browser, you get the. So whenever you load your browser, you get your contents there. Okay. 1 minute, I'll show you. So what if you change this? If you change this, you have to change in your browser. Say we are doing this home. Okay, so let me save this. After saving, as you can see, I'm gonna restart my server and then start. Yep, we have restarted, and then if you load this, it won't work because there is no route call or controller. Sorry, there is no route which says users. Okay. Even home route we don't, sorry, even the by index route we don't have. What we have is slash home. Okay. Yeah. So if you go this, you are getting this. Okay. So that is how we maintain our routes. So for now, let me have this. Okay. We'll change, we'll create our own routes in future. And as you can see, we are setting our messages, error messages, everything. But you can't see your code. Okay, your project is running on 3000 port, but you can't see that. Where is that? So as you can see, whenever we do come to the package.json, whenever I am doing npm start, okay, we are calling this script. Okay, so npm is the command, and the start is coming from here. What it is saying is node is the command to run any node.js file, and /bin/www. Okay, so here you come .bin and www is the file, and as you can see, we are calling our app here, that is our app.js, and then our server, that is debug, nothing, just don't care about that right now. HTTP module we are calling here, and then we have our port here. Okay, so let me print a message here so that we come to know if we change our port. In future, we will come to know what port are we running. So we say server is listening to port and the port number. Okay. So whatever port our server is listening, it will give you that. Okay. Let me change the port and let me show you. Because in future, by default, React.js gives you 3000. So anyhow, that will run. But let me change this to 5000. Just to show you guys. And variable server, HTTP create server is the command to create server, is the function to create server. Server.listen, and that's it guys, there is nothing else to worry about. Okay. Yeah. So this is the benefit of using Express generator. You don't have to work on that. like creating server and all. It gives you a complete setup of the basic project, very basic project. And now let me run npm start. Okay. And then now you can see server is listening to port 5000. Let me come here, let me run this project. You will get error because there is nothing called 3000 port. So you get the site can't be reached. Okay. And if I change this to 5000, again you will get error because we change our directory, I mean home route as just slash, nothing home. Now if I change this, you get this. Okay. So that's it, guys. In this video. And we'll meet very soon in next tutorial, and in that I'll tell you how to set up our MongoDB, how to do that, and what project are we going to work on, and I'll tell you very real time project in which we are gonna make blogging, sign up, login, users, everything we are gonna do that. Okay, so see you soon, guys. Take care. Bye bye. Thank you.